and tell yourself, I know my knees are hurting. I know my head is itching. But I'm going to ignore that. And the more you ignore it, the more it itches. But if you get past that, it will stop itching. It will stop hurting. And you will find yourself in quietness, solitude within the self, the mind, the thoughts, the no thoughts, the sounds, the no sounds. Meditation is simply awareness. If you would like to know more about breathing, meditation, consciousness, awareness, healing, relationships, learning how to eat, how to live, then come. Come to some of our workshops. We have workshops throughout the month. We have workshops continuously. If you have problems sleeping, we have a workshop that's called Yoga Nidra. Yoga Nidra is a sleep-like meditation where you don't sleep. So for more information, come out to the workshops, come out to yoga, and let's learn more. Pranayama is one of the eight limbs of yoga. Pranayama is breathing, your breath, and breath awareness. People are not aware that they do not know how to breathe. They will say, I must be breathing, I'm living. Yeah. However, when you learn to breathe, you wonder, how were you living? How could you live with such a shallow breath? Breathing and breath awareness comes from deep within the body, the lungs, the diaphragm. It comes in through the nose, out through the nose. It can come in through the nose and out through the mouth. But breathing out through the mouth is a cooling breath. You find that most runners breathe out of the mouth to cool their bodies. Or when you're working out at the gym, you might find that, you know, you breathe out of the mouth. But theoretically, you should breathe in and out through the nose. When you breathe in and out through your nose, it activates and stimulates your respiratory system, your lungs. It gives you oxygen, air in the body, air for the blood, the tissues, the muscles, the arteries. Air moves things. Air makes things flow. And when you're breathing consciously and slow and deep, you bring this oxygen, this energy into every cell, every limb, every artery, in the mind, in the body, in the spirit, in the soul. Breath and breathing is so important until for those who have anxiety attacks, they're simply holding their breath. But they're not aware that they're holding their breath because they're holding their breath out of habit. And habits form from early on in our childhood when we become frightened and scared. Way back from mommy's womb, because when mommy became frightened, she held her breath, which cut off your breath, and it became second nature to you. So when you came out into the world, you already knew how to hold your breath because mommy taught you. But you can learn to breathe. You can learn to rebreathe and to breathe deeper by being conscious and aware of your not breathing, or your shallow breathing, or your heart breathing. Breathing, breath, it should be in rhythm. The inhales, the exhales, and with each inhalation, the mind and the body should be at peace. With each exhalation, the mind and the body should be at peace. You will find that if you were to get angry, they would say to you, count your breaths, inhale to the count of 10, exhale to the count of 10. And by that time, air would have gotten to your brain, to your thoughts, and you yourself would have calmed down. Just say you were ready to fight, and you're huffing, and you're puffing. And they say, breathe, breathe. And you breathe. Oh, man, forget it. You just walk away. Because the breath connected with the brain, connected with your senses, calmed you down. Breathing is crucial. It's your life. So learn to breathe. Learn to be conscious and aware of the breathing. At night, in the day, throughout the day, close your eyes or don't close your eyes. Just focus on the inhalations and the exhalations. And each time, making each inhale deeper than the last. And exhale just as deep, just as long, or longer than the inhales. Inhale to the count of 7. Exhale to the count of 8. When you inhale, the belly rises. When you exhale, the belly goes in. However, if you were a smoker, or if you are a smoker, your breathing is totally off and reverse, because you have to draw in the cigarette, which is not expanding, but collapsing. So the pattern is all off. And when you are a smoker or have smoked, and you begin to be conscious of your breath, you will realize the damage you did to your lungs and how you have shortened your life. Breathing slow and deep prolongs your life. What does one need to take yoga at Happy Hour Yoga? It is so simple. You only need yourself. That's all. Come, and we will take care of the rest. We have mats, we have blocks, we have whatever you need except you. Come to Happy Hour Yoga. We will take care of the rest. No frills, no deals, just come. Tony's Happy Hour Yoga is at 6504 Old Branch Avenue in Temple Hills, Maryland. The zip code is 20748 if you choose to Google it. The telephone number, 301-449-8664. The website, happyhour-reiki.v/victor-p-as-in-paul-web.com. You will find the hours and the prices on the website. Namaste.